Miss Malik.
Here what you time go. Is it?
Nighttime.
Hello, everybody. My name is Vivian Valenzuela Malik, and I'm the new director of admissions and financial aid at the Bishop School. I just moved here a few months ago from the East Coast, and I brought with me my 8-year-old daughter, who is currently in the third grade. And every time she comes to visit me at the Bishop School, she keeps asking me, when can she go to Bishop's? She's very disappointed that it doesn't start earlier than sixth grade. We have both been so impressed with everything that Bishop's has to offer, the joy of learning, a strong sense of school spirit, and a wonderful community of passionate, dedicated educators, like the ones who have joined us this evening, and students. So welcome to our very first nighttime session of the year. Tonight, we're going to talk about the middle school experience, so anything and everything that has to do with grades 6 through 8. We are so grateful for your interest in our school and that you've chosen to spend some time with us this evening to learn more about Bishop's. I want to say a huge thank you to my colleagues on the call, Mr. Klein and Ms. Tanner, for taking time out of their busy schedules to be here with us, and to our 4 student panelists who you're about to meet for also being here and sharing their experiences. And huge shout out to my friend and colleague, Mr. Francis Donald, who oversees middle school admissions at Bishop's and organized this entire virtual event. Take it away.
All right. Well, again, my name is Francis Donald. Thank you, Ms. Malik, and welcome to your first ever Bishop's virtual event. I am one of our associate directors of admissions, specifically for middle school, and I'm so glad to be here with you tonight. Before I introduce Ms. Tanner, we wanted to kick things off with some trivia. And so we've got 2 Bishop's trivia questions that we are going to throw out there. And so to get us in the spirit of using the Q&A, as we move through the evening, you're going to have an opportunity to ask questions using the Q&A. The first person to answer the question correctly will win a prize that shall be determined at a later date, but you can bet that it will be maroon and gold and may even say Bishop's on it. So the first question is, and this is a layup, we're going to get things warmed up here. What year was the Bishop's School founded? In what year was the Bishop's School founded? Oh, and we've got an answer right away. A lot of 1909 coming in. That is right. 1909. I should have asked a harder question. Okay, here's a, so we've got a winner here. I won't say the name out loud, but we've got a winner. I'm marking that down. And then the next question is, in what year was the tower on top of the chapel built?
Oh, that's a much harder question, Mr. Donald.
Do we have any takers? I don't see it yet. There it is. I've got a winner. 1930. 1930 is the answer. So we've got a couple, okay, now they're starting to file in. Excellent. Awesome. Thank you for participating. We've got a couple winners. We'll be back with more trivia after this, but I'm going to kick it to Ms. Tanner to tell you a little bit about herself and what she does for our middle school community. Ms. Tanner.
Hi, everyone. Thank you for joining tonight. I am a sixth grade English teacher, and I'm also the director of middle school student life. So with that position, I get to manage all of our amazing clubs. The kids get to choose between a club that they want to join during lunch, and it's spread out all throughout our cycle so that they can join as many clubs as they'd like to. Some of the clubs that we have is Night Writers, where we do creative writing. We have Junior Model UN. We also have a Better Bros Club, which Mr. Donald runs. We have a garden club, so the kids get an opportunity to work in our garden and bring some amazing vegetables home. In addition to our clubs, I also help manage Period X, which is special for middle school. It's an opportunity for middle school students to participate in sports and also other extracurricular activities such as arts. And we're actually going to be starting a happiness class, which would be amazing. I'm very excited about that one. I also run our social emotional program where we look at how our emotions and our interactions socially are also intertwined with our social media experiences and how we can present ourselves in a more positive light while we are using technology. So with all of that, the students get a lot of different opportunities to explore all sorts of amazing extracurricular activities, and they get to also explore what it means to be a member of our middle school community. So I'm gonna send it over to Mr. Klein.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Harlan Klein, and I'm proud to be the head of the middle school at Bishop's. I've been at Bishop's for 4 years, and something that never ceases to stop impressing me is the amount of freedom and discretion that students have at this school. So for those of you that have students entering middle school for the first time, you shouldn't be surprised to know that by the end of their first year of middle school, probably 2/3 of their friends are going to change. And that's totally normal and acceptable. The reality is they're coming mainly from environments that are perhaps more socially isolated or a bubble if they're coming from elementary school. But when they come to Bishop's, they are embarked on a journey of like 70 different zip codes, lots of different students coming from different walks of life, and they're immersed in that environment. They get to be part of a grade level, but they also get to be part of an advisory. And advisory is how we start our day every single day. Myself, Mr. Donald, Mrs. Tanner, one of the cool things is we all get to be advisors. So we each have a small group of students. It's usually 10 to 12 students. And that's how we start our day every day. So that builds a family within a small family. And so that's another way that students get to meet each other on a deep level. And that's how they start their day every day. That's also where a lot of our enrichments happen. Another great thing about middle school is the connections that we allow students to make. They find things that they are interested in, and then they notice that other kids that they may not have known previously have similar interests. And that's how those friendships begin. And the reason I mentioned that their friends are going to change, I focus a lot on friendships because in middle school, that's like the number one thing. And it's not to say that parents aren't important. You're the most important teachers. But the reality is middle school is a time where their friends become more and more important. And that is their world. And the good news is that Bishop's, there's a tremendous number of awesome young people to be friends with. And the reason why friends change a lot is because they change a lot. And that's what I liked about middle school is that how they enter in sixth grade and how they depart in eighth grade, it is a completely different person, a different human being, barely recognizable. And they are influenced and they get to develop and mature in an environment where they have a lot of caring adults trying to help them navigate this challenging, awkward, and awesome time in their lives. And so when I talk about students, I think you should see students. So let's have our student panelists join our meeting here. And what we're asking, I'm gonna repeat what Mr. Donald said. He and I are gonna be moderating the Q&A, and we would love for you to get your questions answered by putting them in the Q&A, and we're gonna toss them to specific students or we'll answer them ourselves if it's something that the students may not know the answer to. Okay, how do we get the students on there? Let's see them. I'm gonna answer the first question myself actually before I toss with the students. The question was how many students were in seventh grade? Now let's give you the breakdown in general for all the middle school grades. So sixth grade has anywhere between 60 and 63 students. That's the target number for sixth grade. Seventh grade is about 100 students, maybe a couple more, but about 100. Eighth grade, again, about 100. It's interesting because in seventh grade, about 40% of the students are brand new to Bishop's. And that's an exciting time for these new students to break into a grade level, realizing they're one of a number of students that are new to Bishop's. In eighth grade, it's a very small number of new students entering, but the middle school consists of about 270 students total. Okay, so let's do some student introductions. We'll start with, let's start with sixth grader, Ritika. Why don't you unmute and introduce yourself?
Hi, my name is Ritika and my current grade is sixth grade and it is my first year at Bishop's. I love all of my classes, but if I had to choose one, my favorite one would probably be English with Miss Tanner. And my favorite lunch, it's really hard to choose, but I don't know exactly what it's called, but it's the garlic bread with the baked cheese pasta.
Good choice. Let's move up to, well, my screen is up, Lucas.
Hi everyone, my name is Lucas. I'm a seventh grader here. I joined Bishop's last year in sixth grade. My favorite class is the arts rotation here and the lunch. I love all the lunches here, but my favorite one was a pulled pork. It's really good.
Okay, Lucas, I'm gonna stick with you for a second because one of the questions has to do with creative and performing arts, and you just mentioned the arts rotation. So can you remember sixth grade? And if you can't, you can phone a friend over there to Ritika, but tell us about the rotation you did in sixth grade, what you've done in seventh grade, and what you look forward to doing.
Yeah, so arts rotation in sixth grade was like, we did a lot of art. We did, I think drama club, not club, sorry. We did drama, we did singing. So like that's choir. And we also did Bishop's, it was, I think, band. So it was, we got to compose music and play music. This year, so far, I've only done two arts rotations. And that was technical theater, which was really fun. And now I'm in coding. So but yeah, they're very good. There's a wide variety.
Thank you. And did you mention your favorite lunch, Lucas?
Yeah, pulled pork.
Pulled pork. Okay. I'll come back and I'll talk more about the arts rotations because I think that's another fine attribute of our school. Audrey.
Hi, everyone. I'm Audrey. I'm currently in eighth grade. I started Bishop's in sixth grade. And my favorite class would probably have to be math because I like love my teacher, Miss Scott. And my favorite lunch is probably also the garlic bread and the baked pasta.
Okay. And Jacob.
Good evening. My name is Jacob and I'm in eighth grade. I'm a new student here. And my favorite class probably so far would be science class. I find really high interest in it. And my favorite lunch would probably be pizza, which is really rare and they should sell it more.
Okay. I'm moderating the questions, but I want to talk a little bit and I'm going to ask you about your period X in the second, students. I want to talk a little bit more about creative and performing arts at Bishop, specifically in the middle school. So in sixth grade, in addition to what Lucas mentioned, there's also ceramics is one of the rotation classes. And so what's great about sixth grade is that there's no choices for classes for students. Their electives are a wheel. So in sixth grade, they have a wheel of arts. So they have 2D, 3D art, choir, instrumental music, drama. So they rotate through all of those different art opportunities. In seventh grade, there's also an art rotation, a little bit different, but they have some of the same type of classes in addition to technical theater where they're designing sets and lighting, but they also do the opportunities for drawing and painting. That's all part of the seventh grade art. They also have a digital class, which is a class focused on technology. So that's part of the art opportunities in sixth and seventh grade. When they get to eighth grade, that's when they get to select their elective for the first time. And so there are art electives, and there's also other types of electives such as robotics. So there's a lot of electives that they get to choose in eighth grade. The other rotation that they have in sixth and sixth grade rotation are the language, world languages. And so in sixth grade, they do it by quarter. So every student will have in sixth grade a quarter of French, a quarter of Latin, a quarter of Chinese, and a quarter of Spanish. And they rotate through those world languages with a specific group of students. That's for getting them exposure. Then at the end of the year, they get to choose what world language they want to take as their world language starting in seventh grade. And then that typically becomes the language that they continue in eighth and in high school. So that's all kind of by design in sixth and seventh grade. Arts are a guaranteed opportunity, and then language. In addition, I think Lucas he mentioned drama club. So that's another opportunity for students. That's an after-school opportunity that's run by two of our art teachers. And that's focused on improv games, focused on theater and drama. And so that's a club that students get to go. It's walk-in, no sign up, no registration. It's just show up and have fun. And typically that happens on Thursdays after school. There's always a middle school play that students, that's an audition-based opportunity. So if a student is interested in art, whether it be on stage, playing an instrument, there's lots of opportunities in middle school for them to dig into that. No experience necessary. All right, so I think I said a little bit more about that. I hope that answered your question. Okay, so here's another question on throughout there. And this might be for you, Mrs. Tanner. You mentioned some of the clubs, but they want to know, can you talk about the different clubs and activities? So I'll throw it to students first. So Mrs. Tanner, talk about some of the clubs, and then if any of you students are in a specific club, would you just give me a finger up and I'll have you talk more about that specific club and why you chose it?
Sure. So our clubs range from things focused on history and geography. So we have the History and Geography Club, and we also have Junior Model UN. In addition to that, we have the Better Bros Club, focused on positive masculinity. We have a club called the Femme Club. And are any of you, Ritika and Audrey, are you in Femme? No? Okay. In addition to that, we also have Night Writers. Again, that's a creative writing club. We have Garden Club, and we just started an art club. So what's wonderful about the clubs is that the students are the ones who create the clubs. It is focused on the students essentially running the clubs, and then you have teacher sponsors who are there supporting the students running it. So I am the sponsor for the Creative Writing Club, but I have two eighth graders who run the entire club. They create the curriculum for it, and then my sixth and seventh graders go along with it. So I think that's all of our clubs. I'm trying to remember if I'm forgetting any of them. We're always adding ones throughout the year. So we start off with just a few, and then by the end we have several going throughout all of our lunches.
Out of curiosity, are any of these students in any specific clubs? Those are voluntary and they happen during extended lunches a couple of times during our cycles. Okay, something else that happens that are opportunities for you after school, we also have I call it math club, but it happens after school. That's run by upper school students and they prepare to do specific math competitions. So that's another opportunity for students who have an interest in that topic to join a group of students that have a similar interest. And again, these are all things that are available to students on a voluntary basis. Okay, here's a question about homework. I know my answer, what it should be, but the question is, how much homework do you have per night? About how long does it take you? Okay, so let's start with sixth grade. And by the way, students, we want your direct, honest answers here, right? So I'm really curious to know if it falls within the expectation. So Bishops has a policy on how much homework students should have per night. And so I'm wondering if this is going to reflect that, and I assume it's going to. So Ritika, how much homework do you have per night?
So not all my classes and every day will give me homework, but I have a pretty good amount, not too much, not like nothing at all, but it usually takes me about an hour or less, depending on if I have a project or not that I want to put more effort into. So, yeah.
Okay. How about you, Lucas? How much homework do you have?
Not much. Same how Herdika was saying, but about an hour or so. And if I'm working on a project, maybe a little bit more. But it's very easy. Some of the teachers told me spend 25 minutes on some homeworks, no matter where you are. So it's good. Yeah.
Yeah. And Audrey, if you can describe how the homework expectation has increased from your experience at Bishop's into becoming an eighth grader.
Okay. Well, in sixth grade, I had like less homework than I would have now, but it's still like pretty similar amount. Like it hasn't increased that much and it's still manageable. I'd say like each class I have like 25, 30-ish minutes. But sometimes teachers will be nice and won't give homework. So yeah.
Yeah. And something to think about, and it's intentional, is our schedule is very supportive of allowing students to balance their out of school lives. And we have a lot of students that have extracurricular things that they do that they are really invested in. And so to balance that, our schedule is very supportive. So if you've never seen our schedule, it's a 7-day rotating schedule. The classes rotate. So if you have math or English at first period of the day today, tomorrow you wouldn't have that same class. The only time you have 1 day of the 2 days of the week where a class would be on two consecutive days. Otherwise, you always have a break in between before that class meets again, and it will meet at a different time of the day. So it looks very confusing on paper, but it's really easy to get used to once you've lived it for a week. The reason that we do that, or one of the main reasons we do that, is to balance out. So typically nothing that's assigned for homework is due the very next day. So students are learning how to prioritize and make decisions and balance and manage their own time in terms of doing homework, because they only have homework for certain academic classes and it's typically not due the very next day. And because of our cycle, we only have 4 classes that meet on any given day. And so if you're a 6th or 7th grader, or for some of the 8th grade electives, those are classes that typically do not have homework. And so it's very likely that a student would have an elective class or a rotation class plus a PE class without homework, right? And then they may have 2 academic classes that are assigning homework. Typically, it's about a half an hour, 25 minutes, but it's usually never due the very next day. So teachers are very supportive of balancing the level and the amount of homework, and really do appreciate when students share with them how long something is taking, especially if it's too long. And oftentimes that's the student making that choice and it's different than what the teacher's expecting them to do. All right.
Mr. Klein.
Yes.
Thank you. Stop. Can I just jump in here for 1 second? I think when you mentioned the schedule, I thought of the X period question we were going to ask the students. And there's a lot of questions in the Q&A about X period and sports.
Well, here we go. Let me start with that then. Good point. Okay. So we have something, this is one of my favorite parts of the day, which is called Period X. It's a middle school phenomenon. And what I like about it is that this is a student's opportunity to choose another elective or a sport. So we call it Period X. It stands for extracurricular. That's where our middle school sports happen. It changes 3 times throughout the year. And it happens 4 out of 7 days to end the day for the last hour. And includes, like I said, sports. So though they would have competitions, they participate and compete against other schools if they're in a sport. So the question I would like to ask you students, what is your period X? And for those of you that have been at Bishop's previously, if you can share what are some of the other period X things that you've done, not just what you're doing right now for trimester 1. So this time I'm going to start with Jacob, who's a new student. So he's his first period X experience. Jacob, what are you doing for Period X?
For Period X, I'm currently doing flag football with Coach Gozum, and it's pretty fun.
Okay. And you had your most recent game just the other day, right?
Oh, yeah, right. It was against Francis.
Okay, so all of our sports We compete in South Coast League, and depending on the level of team that a student is on, they compete in this league. And only one of the teams, which is our maroon team, is there to win a championship. All the other teams is a no cut policy. Everyone makes a team. They have the opportunity to focus on fun and fundamentals. That's the focus of our sports program. Ritika, it's also your first time in Period X. What did you choose?
I chose volleyball, and I play with Coach Scott.
Excellent. And I know you have games as well. And Audrey, I hope you can elaborate. What are you doing right now for Period X, and what have you done in the past?
Okay, so for right now, I'm doing lacrosse. And in sixth grade and seventh grade, I also did lacrosse in the fall. But there's also like other sports that are offered. So I've done like field hockey and tennis and basketball. And there's like cross country. There's a lot of X period sports and a lot to choose from. But I really like lacrosse with Coach Diddy and Coach Carr.
Excellent. And Lucas.
So last year I did Bishop's Rocks, which is the Bishop's classic rock band. That was really fun. And I did that twice. And then I did robotics. That was really fun too. We learned how to program robots and build them. And this year I'm doing open aquatics, which is like a mixture of water polo, swimming, water activities. And it's really fun too. But it's nice when you can get into the pool at the end of the day.
All right, so that gives you a sense right there. There are a lot of opportunities and choices for students. Lots of sports, changes by season, but there's a lot of extracurriculars. So Lucas mentioned robotics. Sometimes we offer junior model UN as a Period X or as a club opportunity. The aquatics is a swimming opportunity. In the springtime, we have water polo, baseball. So there's sports. And then there's also for students that have lots of extracurricular commitments outside of school, there's also a voluntary study hall for them if they just need time to get work done during the day. So there's academic opportunities, athletic opportunities, and artistic opportunities. Jacob, there's a specific question for you. Knowing that you are a new student coming to Bishop's in eighth grade, the question is, can you just share a little bit about what it's been like to join the eighth grade when most of your peers were at Bishop's in maybe sixth or seventh grade? How was that transition for you?
My first day at Bishop's was actually pretty nice, and the community was really welcoming, and it seemed that I fit in pretty quickly, and everyone was kind, no one was really mean, and I had a fun time.
Great. Jacob, why don't you tell a little bit about retreat and how that helped you cement some of it? Why are you laughing? Tell us a little bit about retreat.
Retreats was pretty fun. It was like pretty crazy out there, and we had like a lot of different activities that we got to do. And I've never been in the wild like that before or slept like in an open cabin before. It was definitely something new and fun. I got to meet my classmates better and know them better. And it was just like a bond. Yeah, and we did a relay race and we swam in a pool. We had like a flipping contest and it's pretty fun.
Yeah, so that's something that happens typically in the first month of school for seventh and eighth graders. We do overnight retreats. So it's two overnights where they get to be with their peers and their advisors. And without parents, of course. And that's an opportunity for them to kind of step away from their comfort zone and have this shared bonding experience. There's a curriculum that goes with it and just a lot of opportunities for students to do activities and kind of step out of their comfort zone in a challenge by choice situation. Thank you. Lucas, do you recall last year your robotics? The question is, what kind of coding did you do in robotics? Do you know what you remember?
I think we used Arduino. If I say all right, but yeah, it was kind of still like the introduction to robotics. And then I think in upper school, there's a really good robotics team. But yeah, it's really fun.
And in eighth grade, there was actually a robotics class if students are interested in that. And those are students, we moved away from Lego robotics. And so they are programming, they use C-Perch, and they are doing one other cool thing about our Period X robotics is that that's another class that's sponsored by our robotics teacher, but actually instructed by three high school students that are competitive in the area of robotics. And they do all of the lesson planning and coaching in that Period X. So to give them the leadership opportunity. Okay, let me look at these questions here. I'm gonna take this one myself. The question is, does Bishops participate in any national science competition such as Science Olympiad, Science Bowl? We do participate in Science Bowl. And we also participate in multiple math competitions. So through our middle school program, we participate in Math Olympiad. Plus we have teams that compete in math competitions. So that's another opportunity for students to participate and compete in areas, academic areas for which they have a background and interest. Let me look at the chat and see here. Okay. Art rotation, we covered that. Mrs. Tanner, you forgot about middle school SOS. Please talk about that peer support type stuff.
Sure. So in all the clubs that I was trying to list, I left off a few. So I saw some of the questions come up about our service opportunities. We do have a club that is focused on students of service. And so those students actually create service opportunities for our middle school. So they're broken down into different groups based on their grade level. And the sixth grade group will decide on a project for all sixth graders to participate in. And same thing for seventh and eighth grade. And when it comes to peer support, that is another program that I run. We have a peer support program run in the upper school by Ms. Broderick, and I will run the middle school version of that. It's our second year running, and it focuses on finding opportunities for peers to connect. And so those were the two, some of the questions came up about that. So thank you for letting me answer those.
Great. Here's a great question right here. And it's directed for all of you students. The question is, do you feel a lot of pressure academically in terms of the workload, teacher expectations, or competitiveness amongst your classmates and yourself? Is there a lot of pressure? Do you feel a lot of pressure academically at Bishops? Lucas,
No.
Tell us about that.
Yeah, no pressure at all, really. The teachers do a very good job, teaching and making sure everyone knows, where they are. And, everyone's really nice there. The students are really nice. Definitely there's not any pressure.
Audrey, do you have a different answer or something to follow up on?
I think that the academics, I do not think it's very pressuring, but I do think that obviously as you go on and I'm in eighth grade, but in the eighth grade, obviously the academics get harder. But for me, I use it as an opportunity to go to office hours and if I'm not understanding a topic, it's also it's my part. I need to do my part too and stuff. So I like to go to office hours and stuff. But I don't think it's competitive
Okay. And there could be different answers for that. So one of the things that we found when we did our student surveys is that there is some form of competition, and Bishops has taken that directly to help build a culture where students are not directly comparing themselves. It's influenced our grading practices. It's influenced how we report and how we honor students. And so we want students to be academically minded and perform, but we also want them to set reasonable boundaries. And the reality is many of our students, the pressure that they put on comes directly from themselves. It's sometimes disconnected from what the teachers are expecting. Audrey made a really good point right there where she said about office hours. And so that's something that's fairly unique about Bishops. is that every single teacher is available after school by design and by schedule for at least a half an hour after school. That's dedicated time for students to walk in without appointment to get extra support or extra help. But office hours isn't only for extra support and extra help. It's also a place where students can just go to a welcoming environment to get work done. And it happens if a student rides the bus home, the office hours end before the first bus leaves. And so I often suggest the new parents to make office hours part of your regular instructional day. It's something good happens when a kid shows up. That's the first step, showing up. Office hours works best if they show up with a specific issue they have, a question for the teacher. But if they just show up in an environment where other students are there working, that's a great place for them to go. And Ritika, looks like you're having a visceral response. What are you thinking about that?
It's all very agreeable that office hours is very important, because I do take the bus, so it is a part of my everyday. And just when I have a problem, it is so, so helpful to be able to just walk in so quickly and just ask a question and get clarity so that I'm able to work my best on what I'm trying to do. And it just really helps a lot to have that kind of dedicated time to be one-on-one with your teacher and just to get a better depth of what you're learning or trying to do.
Awesome. Someone was asking about a dance program. Our dance program, we have a set. Audrey, you want to talk about dance?
Sure. Okay, so I'm not in their dance program, but during school, we do have a dance rotation. For like a PE unit, we do dance. And also for eighth grade, there's something called MT8. It's music theater for like eighth grade, and I'm in it, and we do a lot of dancing. It's really fun. I really recommend it. But it's just like music theater. It's like singing and dancing, but it offers like a good opportunity to try new things, and especially like dance. Like, I don't know, like I've like never danced before, and it was like a great opportunity. So yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna answer one more question. And I noticed there's more questions in the chat. So for all of you who did not get your specific questions answered, I'm really easy to find. Go to the Bishop's website. I'm happy to answer any specific question for you. The admissions, there's some questions that are specific to admissions. Those are best answered individually by one of our admissions faculty. But the question here that I wanted to ask is, let me pick a good one here to end on. The question.
Oh, I got one.
Got one? Go ahead, Vivian.
Someone wanted to know about how the Episcopal values of the school has helped students in their well-being, and how do they integrate it and carry it into their futures?
Okay, that's a good question. Any student would like to take a stab at that before I answer, in my opinion? You can talk about a chapel. You can talk about anything that you've heard in chapel, any of our guest speakers that you've had, even as recently as yesterday. Let's go with Ritika, go ahead.
Yesterday, there was a speaker who came to school that works with anxiety in kids and all the way to adults. And it was just really nice to listen to her talking about just anxiety in general, because I don't know, there's just so many people that talk at school that makes everything feel so relatable, to make you feel like you're not alone. And they always talk about tools to help you if you are going through something like that. And I feel like it's just so helpful in creating a better environment and a better community in students.
Audrey, did you want to say something about chapel specifically?
So basically chapel is once every cycle, but I think it's really helpful just to kind of have a space, because like even if maybe you're not like Episcopal or Christian, it's just always good to have like a place just like kind of like sit in silence and like take your time to like think, and like it's, those talks are always good. Like Miss Tanner gave like a talk last week, which is like a really, really good talk. So just, yeah, shout out to Stanner.
And so I'll talk a little bit more about the our chapel program and our Episcopal tradition. So something that comes out of the Episcopal tradition is tied in to programs at our school. So our Episcopal values are tied into our diversity, equity, and inclusion values. Those are tied into our advisory. That's tied into our wellness program. So we are really trying to be very intentional to connect all of these things around guiding themes. And so this year, our guiding theme is around kindness. We've had themes and we focus on service, or we focus on humility or justice. And so those are things that are part of our chapel program. It's fairly non-denominational. It's every student can find some leverage point in our chapel program. And the Episcopal tradition is to have a wide degree of inclusion and to help students kind of figure out how they are representing themselves in this world, and gives them things to think about that help them figure out, you know, how to be their best and most authentic selves. That's something that I appreciate about bishops, and something I didn't know before I came there. And I asked similar questions before I came to bishops. So I had an idea of what it would be like to be at a school that values an Episcopal tradition. And so that's something that I think if you should ask more about on your tour, and you'll get a sense of how that kind of brings students together through a shared experience on values, not on religion necessarily, but on shared values.
That's awesome. Thank you to the students. Thank you to Mr. Klein for answering all those awesome questions. I'll give you a round of applause to the students. Thank you. We want to thank everybody who attended this evening for your great questions. I know the chat is still blowing up with questions, and we really appreciate your interest. We do want to be sure that all of your questions are answered, and the best way to do that is to come for a family tour. And there we'll be able to walk the campus, take you into some of our classrooms, show you all of the different spaces that pertain to your students' potential life here at the Bishop School. And we can talk about it in the context of your family specifically. We are open for tours. Now, we have been doing them since October. Our application has also been open since October, and the deadline date is February 1st. It's fairly easy to enter into our application process. You go to our website, bishops.com. We have an admissions page and apply to bishops page, and you can access the portal right there. And as soon as you finish your application form, we are happy to schedule an in-person or virtual interview with one of our admissions team members. I also want to put a plug in for our open house events. We have two open house events coming up in December that we'll be sending out save the dates for. On December 4th, we are having an athletics open house where you can come and be coached by some of our coaches and play on some of our fields and spaces. On December 11th, we'll have an all-school open house where we will have teachers and programs on display, so you can ask questions directly to people like Mr. Klein, people like Ms. Tanner, and really uncover those burning questions that you have about bishops. But as always, we are here for you. Again, my name is Francis Donald. I can be reached via email or by phone, and my information is on our bishop's website. So again, we want to be mindful for your time, and thank you for spending 45 minutes with us this evening. This will be posted online tomorrow at some point, so if you want to check back or have your student watch it if they weren't able to, you'll be able to do that pretty quickly. So I'll ask our students to give one final wave, and thank you to everyone for coming out tonight, and we will see you soon on campus.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Bye, everyone.
Thanks, Mr. Klein.
Thank you.